Greetings again, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Here we have another algebraic exponential equation that we're going to solve. In this equation, we have x to the power of x is equal to 36, and we are given to find the value of x. Now, this looks like a very fun one to do. You may feel free to pause this video and see if you can do this one by yourself. You may also check out my Math Olympiad playlist or my Lambert W Function playlist to see how to solve equations like these ones. Now, as we begin to solve this equation, you may want to save this video for future reference. You can smash that like button and subscribe to my channel, as I will be posting more videos on these types of math problems. Now, I must confess to you that normal algebraic methods cannot be used to solve these problems. So we will be using a special kind of function called the Lambert W function. Now, this is a special kind of function that is used to solve variables where the variable is in the base and also in the power. So how this works is that if we have an expression such as a times e to the power of a, where you see a in the base and also in the power, if you apply a W function to this expression, the result is just a. So what does this mean? It means that we're going to take this equation and we're going to write it in the form of this expression, a times e to the power of a. So taking this equation, we start by taking the natural log of both sides of this equation. So we say that ln x to the power of x is equal to ln 36. Now, from here, we can take ln x to the power of x, and we can rewrite it using this logarithm rule here, where we have ln a to the power of b. This is the same as saying b ln a. So then we are going to take this form of this expression and we are going to apply it on ln x to the power of x. So that means that we're going to say x ln x is equal to ln 36. And as we continue to write our equation so that we have an expression such as a times e to the power of a, we therefore need to have the value e here. So what this means is that we need our equation to have an expression where e is involved. So this x, we can write it in terms of e. So we write x in terms of e by saying x is equal to e to the power of ln x. Now, how this works is that we're not ln. Ln means natural log, where the base of the log is e. So if we have an expression such as e, where e is the base in this case, so we have e as the base, and that is being raised to the power of log base e. The base e here and the log e is going to be cancelled out, and the result is just x. So having this understanding, we can see clearly that x can be expressed as e to the power of log x. So that means we're going to change this x, and we're just going to put the value of e there. So x is equal to e to the power of ln x, and this is going to be multiplying the other ln x here. And this is equal to ln 36. Now, what do we have here? What are we looking at right here? We have e to the power of ln x times ln x. Let's actually go ahead and rewrite this having the ln x first. So we're also going to have ln x times, so we're having that ln x first, times e to the power of ln x. And of course, as we said, this is equal to ln 36. Now, as we said before, we must have an expression such as a times e to the power of a. Let's see if we have that in our equation. So we're looking at this expression. So ln x is in the base and ln x is also in the power. So a is here and also in the power. So we have that. And here we also have e. So what we're saying is that we do have this expression. And if we were to bracket this expression and apply a W function to this expression, the result is a. So we bracket both sides of this equation. So we also bracket the ln 36 as well. And we apply a W function to these expressions. So I'm going to put my W here because there's no space at the front here. All right, with this understanding, we'll just go ahead and rewrite this equation so that we can see exactly what we're looking at. And as we said before, if we apply a W function to a times e to the power of a, the result is just a. And in this case, we can see clearly that a is ln x. The value of a is ln x. So this means we can start by having ln x is equal to W of ln 36, and put that in brackets, of course. So ln x is equal to W of ln 36. Now from here, we continue to solve the value of x by taking the inverse operation of ln here, by saying that x is equal to e to the power of W of ln 36. Now let us see if we can evaluate this expression here to find the value of x right here. So we say that x is equal to e to the power of w of ln 36. Now we can find the value of w of ln 36 and have that raised to the power of e to find the value of x. But I just want to show you another way to actually write this expression. So e to the power of w of x can be rewritten as x over w of x. So what I'm saying is that we can have x is equal to e to the power of w of ln 36, or we could have x is equal to ln 36 over w of ln 36. Now we start to solve the value of x from here by finding the value of w of ln 36. And from here we use Wolfram Alpha, which is going to be our calculating tool. So there we plug in our values and let's scroll down to see the result. So we can see here that the value of w of ln 36 is approximated to be 1.14, I'm just going to round that off to 3, so 1.143. So then this means that x is equal to e to the power of 1.143. So we're just going to have this, and also just going to show you how to rewrite it over here. So we have x is equal to ln 36, so we have ln 36, and we have that over the value of w of ln 36, which we said is 1.143. And now from here we'll just use our scientific calculator and we'll just plug in these values accordingly.
So we said that we have e to the power of 1.143, so just plug that in, let's see what we get. And there we have it, x is equal to approximately 3.1362, rounding off to 4 decimal places.
Now if you like this video so far, please remember to smash that like button and subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for my newest updates on algebraic exponential equations. So our value of x is that x is equal to 3.1362. Now we can actually verify this solution for x by plugging in the value of x into our original equation. So let's go ahead and verify our solution for x. So we verify our solution of x by rewriting our equation as x to the power of x is equal to 36. Now knowing what the value of x is, we just plug in the values of x in the appropriate places.
So then that means we would have 3.1362. So we have that powered by 3.1362. So we have 3.1362 up here as well. And then from here we work this out by using our scientific calculators.
So we plug that in and there we have it. So our solution is true. X is equal to approximately 3.1362. Now thanks again for staying tuned with me to the end of this video. I hope that this was very informative. If you like this video, please remember to smash that like button, share and subscribe to my channel, as I'll be posting more videos on these types of equations. So please stay tuned for my next update, and please remember to check out my Math Olympiad playlist or my other playlist to see how to solve other equations. So catch me in my next video, and until then, thanks again and take care.